Hey gang, it's Bryan from FX Billiards. Today we have one of those videos, one of the ones where the people who need this information most are the ones that didn't click on the video. But I've got to make it. Maybe you can spread the knowledge to some of the people that need this. It's kind of like the "Are You Too Stupid for Pool?" video. Stupid people didn't click on it, so they didn't get the message. And the ones that did click on it, I watched it for 60 seconds and it became a little too familiar to them and they stopped watching anyway. This is one of those videos. We're going to talk about pool room etiquette. And it might be some things that you guys haven't thought about, but I think you should keep in mind. First off, when we talk about pool rooms or pool halls or whatever you want to call them, we're going to lump into that whole thing bars, other people's homes, restaurants where there's a pool table. All of these things apply anywhere you find a pool table. So let's get started. Number one, when you enter a pool room, of course, it's not a library. There's going to be talking, there's going to be laughing, there's going to be joking, there's going to be a lot of things going on. But depending on where you are, there's a good chance there's some serious pool going on. Being outrageous in any way, whether it's physically, verbally, whatever the case, is totally, totally uncalled for. And depending on where you are, and I'm going to probably say this a couple times throughout this video, depending on where you are, it could be very dangerous. Now, I play in some pool halls where if you come in acting like an idiot, you might not make it out of there. At least not in a vertical fashion. There are people playing for lots of money sometimes, and people need to concentrate. This is a game of skill and concentration. Second thing, don't bring your own music. Don't bring your own music or any kind of distraction at all to the pool room. If you're playing your own music in the pool room, there's a problem. So keep down the noise. I don't care if it's a bar, restaurant, whatever. Have fun. Let your personality out. But don't do things that create distractions for other players that are at other tables. Now, if you're on the only table that's in the whole place, you can pretty much act any way you want as long as you don't get kicked out of there. But when there are other people playing, make sure you stay in a reasonable social zone as far as your behavior goes. Next thing, treat a pool table, whether it is in a pool room, a bar, a restaurant, or someone's home, as the absolute most expensive piece of furniture you have ever seen in your life, because that's in many cases exactly what it is. Most people that have a pool table in their house, they don't own a dining room table, a sofa, a television, anything that costs as much as that pool table. So if you're sitting on it, putting drinks on it, eating food off of it, even leaning against it when you don't need to, you're out of line. So treat that as you would the most valuable piece of furniture in anyone's house. Your feet don't belong on it. Your ass doesn't belong on it. You may see some of us in videos sitting on our pool tables as we talk and deliver the message. Pretty bad habit, but you know what? I pay for the pool table. I'll do whatever I want to. I'll set it on fire on the video if I want. But if it's somebody else's property, leaning on it, sitting on it, putting drinks on it, oh my God, you have no idea what it costs to replace the felt on a pool table. Don't do anything that ends with "on it" with somebody else's pool table. Next thing, treat their house cues, whether it's an individual person or a pool hall. Treat the house cues as you would your own cue. Don't leave them leaning up against the table in an angle against the wall. Don't leave it on the floor. Don't turn it upside down. Don't bang it on things. Treat it like you would if that was your own $500 cue. Now, those cues don't cost a lot of money. And one of the reasons they don't cost a lot of money is because the pool rooms won't buy quality house cues because they get abused. But that is someone's property. That is someone's business. And a lot of these businesses manage from week to week, month to month. And with the coronavirus quarantine, a lot of them aren't going to get to open, or when they open, it's going to be a very small percentage of the business that they usually do. And unfortunately, a lot of these places are probably going to go out of business. Which brings me to the next item. When you are at the pool halls, especially in these times, make sure, if you have access to the owner, the manager, or whoever, make sure you let them know that you appreciate what they're doing, that you appreciate their efforts to keep their business running, that you are going to return to that pool hall, that restaurant, that bar, whatever it is, when everything is cleared up and when they can reopen. Make sure they understand that, because that might be the difference in a guy deciding to continue with his business or folding his business up. So make sure you're letting them know that you appreciate what they provide, but treat all of their items with respect. Another thing, when you guys are playing your friends, you know, I used to have a list of ways to find the scrub in a pool hall. So me and my best friend Ernie, we could walk in and not know anybody there and be able to look around the room and tell who the bad players were. One of the dead giveaways is players who, when they miss, they stand right next to the player while their friend, right next to the table while their friend is shooting. If you miss a shot, it's time for you to go sit down, or at least stand in the corner. If you're within 6 feet, 7 feet of that pool table after you miss, you're in somebody else's space. Even if you're playing somebody who's not going to run more than two balls, get out of the way. Don't stand in their light. Don't stand in their area. It's unbelievable. I've played on some college campuses, and guys are literally leaning against the table while somebody else shoots. As I said, a lot of the places where I play, let's just say it would be a very unhealthy practice to lean against the table while a guy's trying to shoot. So that falls into pool room etiquette as well. So this was a short message just to kind of get those points across. I'm sure you guys have some things that you see people doing in the pool room that just are out of line. Hit me in the comments. Let me know what they are. And don't forget to subscribe. Give us a thumbs up. Have a great day. Be safe. And don't forget to let those pool room owners and managers know that you appreciate that place, and that as soon as you can, you're coming back to do business with them, because we need them to stick around.